it's time to do some testing on the new version that just, I think it just came out. I'm not sure. Maybe like, no, it says August 28th. So it just barely came out like a week or so ago. Or two, or three, maybe. I don't know. I'm playing this on Linux, so it's different. It's different in the sense that it may work internally a little bit different. Maybe a little bit slower, faster, I don't know. At least it's better now that the video driver is working, because I wasn't paying attention to an error at the start, and that's why everything was so slow. And now it's fixed, so it's all good. Gotta do the classic one. I don't wanna try anything fancy. I just really wanna learn how everything's changed, because I haven't played RimWorld in about a year. Medium, let's do medium, and let's stay with Cassandra Classic. We could go with Veep Chill X. Should we or should we not? Let's go with Chillax. Let's give it a try first. Let's check that out. I noticed this the other day when I was making some quick playthroughs. I'm not sure exactly if I'm understanding this correctly, but this seems to affect the game in general. And I do want to play commitment mode. I want to be committed. Generate. And we'll wait. And wait. Okay. So let's see. Just a random side. Tropical. Okay. A thick, moist jungle buzzing with animal life and infested with disease despite its visual beauty. This is a very dangerous biome. Choking, overgrowth, aggressive animals, and constant sickness are why some explorers call this the Green Hell. Yeah. Okay, we're gonna do this. I've played all the biomes previously, and yeah, one of the hardest ones is jungle and an ice sheet. Because you'll see. I mean, ice sheet is logical. But jungle, oof, sickness is just hell. Artistic and medical, wow. Got all the stars, even the dreamer, Bonville, traveled across the universe to find the thing he felt he was calling to him. He became poorer and poorer, but used every means possible to carry on. Ooh, this is very Lovecraftian. Something that I can read because of reasons. Beautiful, abrasive. Ugh. Okay. Alright. Mentor. So we have no one that can really fire a gun. You know what? I'm gonna leave this crew as it is. I'm just gonna leave this crew as it is. I'm not gonna change it for anything else. Prediction. Oh no, addictions are the worst. No. At least, they have at least someone, okay, alright. Cooking, crafting, artistic. Alright, you know what? Let's do this. Very neurotic. Okay. Oh, this is gonna be a charm. Let's go. Let's just go do this. Figure it out. Yeah, okay. So we're gonna have infighting as soon as the bonuses for our situation are gone. You know, as you progress throughout the initial month or season, I believe, you start losing the bonus for optimism. That, oh, we made it, so we're gonna start building this colony so we can get off the planet. Because, mind you, the story of RimWorld is... I wouldn't say... I don't know. I don't know if exactly if there's a story or not. I haven't checked again anymore. But, I mean, it's basically all built on random stories. So that's why there's, like... you can have a bad engineered soldier, and then it turns out that he was a medic or a space marine, or he was a spy or whatnot. And all of a sudden, that bad clone soldier is inside this ship, which for whatever reason has it has gone critical. And well, the people that were in the ship try to go into the planet, which is a RimWorld. RimWorld being a planet that is just very, very far away from anything that's civilized. So, I mean, in theory, because there are civilizations inside the planet, because this is an inhabitable planet and blah, blah, blah. So you'll notice that there are tribes which have pre-medieval technology. Then there's people that have crash-landed before, which is a little bit strange, but okay, that still have technology comparable to the industrial age, and there are pirates. Pirates can have a variable amount of technologies, and it can be a hell of a thing to try and fight. Alright, let's do this. Okie dokie. So, what do we have? Old jungle. Okay. Okay. So, anything that's steel, we're gonna grab it. We're gonna remove it for a bit. Same for wood. Food. Clivia. It's Clivia. What is this? Initial plan with tall, pretty flowers. So called the bush lily. Oh, okay, that was alright. I thought it was something else. We got compacting machinery. Nice. I don't want to know what this is. I usually try to stay away from whatever the hell is enclosed behind walls, because like this you don't know what's in there. But that's where some steel is. And okay. Not a fan of doing that. Rhinoceros? Wow. I didn't know they included that. That's interesting. Shallow moving water. Chest deep moving water. So they made it effective. That's nice. That's very nice. Okay. Alrighty. Unforbid everything. Over Rebel Rosalon. Okay. So who's our fighting person here? No, you're not. It's not you. Oh, it's you. Okay. So I'll okay. First things first, because we need to get a base set up as soon as possible. What I like to do is I like to pick up small spaces like this, but these are way too small, and to carry all the stuff around, not cool. So we're gonna make a small shack, and we're gonna start from there. We're gonna do it super simple. It's gonna say that there's not enough store, but we do have that because it's unforbidden, so don't pay attention to that. Now the problem here is, we need to clear ground, or maybe not, or we could do this. There's some land that you can't build upon. Okay, forget about that. Okay, alrighty, no problem, we got it. Wooden door. Okay, now, I'm gonna change this. This is very important. Otherwise, people start doing whatever they feel like. And we don't have anyone that's good at construction. That's going to be a problem. We're going to set up Bonville Priest. Okay. Bonville will be our construction person. Lou will be our warden. Bonville will be our number one doctor. And the second priority is Jay. Do that. Our second, our third research is going to probably be first. Okie dokie. And we're puking. We're puking because of the cryosleep. Every time someone wakes up from cryosleep for a prolonged time, start puking their guts out. That's normal. So don't be scared if you see that, because you might think like, oh my god, they're already sick. But just letting you know, because it took me by surprise the first time. I actually think they have a debuff. You should have a debuff. Health, cryptosleep sickness, consciousness 90%, moving 90%, manipulation 90%, and it just passes away in a couple of hours. Not everybody gets it the same way. Sometimes it just it moves faster. That really depends. Okie dokie. Alright. Furniture. We're gonna do sleeping spots because we don't really have. I'm not gonna say that we don't have time because we do. We do have time. But in other instances, you wanna do this as fast as possible. Like immediately. Oh, you're already cleaning. Okay, thank you. This recreational battery, okay. In the middle of the jungle, because why not? Ooh, there's a poker table now? Oh, construction level 6. Okay, it's pretty high. This is in the middle of luck. Ooh, that's nice. That's a nice, ooh, we have a cat. I will. Can I rename you? Should I? Can I? Tame as flat. Oh, they also changed. Oh, nice. Nice, nice. No, we shouldn't change that, actually. And besides, that's true. You can't tame. Well, you can tame cats, but you can't make them do anything else. It's not like dogs. Dogs can actually help you. They can actually help you do stuff. Like haul items. Why are you the hunter? Why are you the hunter? Okay. We're gonna give you the revolver. Because, yeah. Lou, you're gonna get the rifle. Back in the day, the rifle used to be a Lee Enfield MK4. I'm pretty sure they changed all that because of, let's say, why do I still have this? Ugh. Not sure if I can remove. I'll check it later. But they probably removed it because of legal reasons, because of licensing and whatnot. Sucks for them. It was kind of cool to see, like, oh, you have an Enfield. It's like, this is very ancient technology that you're fighting with. Deal with it. And the revolver is probably a throwback to the Weebly. So, I'm gonna assume that's the reason why it's like that. Although, I can't remember what was the name of the other item. Or the other gun that you had. Because I know it was some sort of pistol. I can't remember what it was, though. But whatever. Okay, let's turn this up a little bit. Okay. Meow. We're gonna need a storage space. Okay. Now, keep this in mind, what I'm about to do could very well put a strain on what you're trying to do, and there reason of that is that people will start hauling stuff here. And this might be bad because you might have auto priorities, but if you remember, we set some of the priorities here. That's number one, number two, number three, whatever. Just gonna change this to two. Mine, wow. Oof, it's gonna be bad. Okay. Number two. Well, we'll figure it out. We'll just go with it. But I did notice something here. Where is it? Production. A butcher spot. Okay, a place for butchering animals. This is very nice. This is very, very, very nice. Because back in the day, you only had the butcher table. And that was it. If you didn't have a butcher table and you didn't have wood, you were done for. There was nothing that you could do about it. Another cool thing is that they put this little chair next to it. Because previously, you wouldn't figure this one out, but bear with me. So you would just put the table down, and people would get tired working. And I assumed that, well, it's because they're working. But no, they were uncomfortable because they had nowhere to sit. But since you had a circle next to it, you will never assume that the circle meant that it was a place for a chair. Go figure that one out. And it's not until now that it's like, oh, okay, that's obvious. A chair is supposed to go there. Okay, fine. Thank you. Thank you for making that obvious after I don't know how many releases. And I think the only reason why I figured this one out was because I saw someone, I think it was Quill18 or someone, that did it. And I'm like, oh my god, really? You can do that? Wow. But the more you know, huh? Oh my god. This guy is just... how do you... No? Oh, okay. Construction 4. Well, it's kind of going up. Personal help. It's not helping our case. No. I'm also thinking about putting floors. Yeah, sure, why not? I'm gonna do this because I can, honestly. Because in other instances, I wouldn't have enough time to do this. It would be like, oh, we got the base. We got this, we got that. Alright. Alright. We got a nice place over our head now. Now you may be wondering, when is electricity coming in? Not anytime soon, I can tell you that much. I mean, it's a good thing that we can build, for example, a generator, a wind turbine. Oh, you don't have solar panels anymore. Oh, that's interesting. Oh, yeah, wind turbine is... Yeah, no. No. And one of the things that really threw me off when I saw it was components. It's just the strangest thing ever. I mean, I looked at it and I thought, well, that's logical. You need some sort of components or electronics or some such to make this work. But when it was made into something that you needed, I was just so thrown off by it because I thought, well, how do you get components? And you can make them later on, but it's costly. It's kind of costly. And I'm not sure I would recommend doing it, like actually building components, unless you have an endless supply of steel. Yeah, no. Otherwise, just forget about it. Oh, and we need a... Oh. Yeah, we need a table. We need a small table. Oh, small wooden table. There we go. Some stools. Sorry if the wooden floor pattern or the place where the floor throws you off, it kind of confuses me sometimes. I don't know if there's a way to remove that, so I don't don't see it, and it only happens when it happens. Like, you just see that the floor is there, and boom, that's it. Okay. Okay. One more. There we go. Nice. Oh, it's gonna get very hot. Oof. Okay, okay, okay. Which is the a passive cooler. Water evaporation. I'm not really sure how this works in real life. I would really like to know. Alrighty. Let's push this up a little bit. Let's make it faster. Are you learning, my good man? Oh, you're learning slowly. Okay. Well, at least that's better inside. And I think we need... Oh, but that's gonna make it very hot, isn't it? I'm pretty sure that's gonna make a really hot room. Where are you? Okay. Produces a small amount of heat. Oof. Okay. Something that bothers me is that, before if they couldn't do it, they wouldn't lose material in the process when constructing. That's kind of like, kind of hurts you when you see that those numbers go down, especially when it's something that you can't easily find wherever you are. For example, steel. In our case, there's some steel around, but I still don't want to play too much with that. Oh no. What's your issue? Sweaty. I know. I know it's sweaty. Oh, but the thing is that you are neurotic, right? Oh. You see that? We're learning crops. What? This is absolutely great. Like, what they're talking about, that's great. I mean, that's a very nice tidbit that you can find in this game. Very Dwarf Fortress-like. And I love it. I absolutely love that. That's why I became a fan of Dwarf Fortress in the first place. Well, all that and because of the, I would say, obscurity of the game. Because if you think about it, Dwarf Fortress is a very obscure game. And not a very easy one to get into. A lot of people would just look at it and be like, oh my god, no. Just get that away from me. No. I'm recording some right now. I mean, I should, actually. But I don't want to do that. I'm actually looking for... what's it called? Harvest. That's what I'm looking for. There we go. Okay. Alrighty, we have a table. Do we have someone else that can cut wood? Plant cut. I don't know if it makes a difference or not. If they have skill in it or not, to be honest. Ooh, bamboo trees. Watching the sunset? Okay. Alright. Oh man. So that's why they made bridges. I mean, I totally understand it now because I was seeing it the other day and I'm like, ah, bridges. And now that I think about it, No. Our crowd is not that good. But we'll have to figure something out with that. I mean, growing potatoes doesn't really require that much of a skill, if I remember correctly. It's just like 3 or 2 maybe. I don't know. Let's check that out. Let's make a small 6x6 for now. Okay, it doesn't require skill. Potato, and I would say corn, because corn yields a lot, and when I mean a lot, it's way too much. Oh, and you can also do beer. Oh, that's so fun. Do the whole beer process. It's, personally, I think it's very slow. It's a very, very, very slow process, how they made it now. But when it started, it was like, it was kind of simplified. So it's cool that they took, I would say, the initiative of doing a whole process. Oh. Someone likes you. That's good. Go for a walk, okay. Oh, nice. Now the question here is, okay, so there is a butcher spot. Electric, okay, fuel stove. Alright. You get the electric smelter now? And the crematorium. Ah, that's, I like that. I really like that. That's very interesting. Fuel stove. We're gonna do this right now. Here. Structure. Furniture. Should I? Sure not. Gonna do wood. Ah, but I can't. Because I don't have wood right now. Okay. So, where's everybody? It's not crafted. Ah, okay. That makes sense. Should be the same. Okay. That's pretty neat. To be honest, that's pretty, pretty neat. I didn't think that something like this had been implemented yet, because you could accidentally start firing. And, well, stuff could happen. Because, you know, Dwarf Fortress. If you ever, read or saw or heard anything about Murder Boat, you'll know what I'm talking about. When things go really haywire and basically everyone starts killing each other. Because Murder Boat. And if you haven't checked it out, highly recommend that you do so. So that you know what's up. What's up with life in general. You know. Okay. Okay. It's hotter in here. Okay. I would assume it's because of all the people inside, and because of the wood, obviously. At this point, we don't have, we don't really have much left to do, but wait until everyone wakes up for the next day. And I'm also thinking that, if I'm not mistaken, we should be getting our next colonist, if that's the right term, in the next 2 days. I think it still works that way, I'm not sure. I just played for a bit, just to see how it felt. But I'm gonna assume that that's still right, that that hasn't changed at all, and that this is how it works. Let's see. Okay, so we're back in action. And obviously this annoys everyone because they can't properly sleep. I don't know why you're eating the berries when you can just eat. Well, now that I think about it, I'm not sure if it's... I think it's because of the appeal. Yeah. It's made for survival, not for appeal. In the end. Sleeper do her own thing. Right now. Okay, so this is Jay. Who's still hauling stuff. I think that's most of it, if not all of it. Maybe not. Oh, someone's killing. Okay. Let's finish mining here. Because the idea is that we can use this entire space. At least the most of it. Let's see. I'm not sure why. Well, that's okay. If they want to clean outside, just clean outside, whatever. Never mind. Chunks of metal we're gonna use later on, and apparently all this stone. I've never figured out why there's always random bits of stone left over, but I'm gonna assume that that's volcanic, in one way or the other. Speaking of, oh, look at that. Survival meals, okay, which are not very far away. Is that? Ooh, nice. Geyser. There's steel over here, but I don't want to go for it yet. There's a ship chunk, okay. We could have used this bit better. That's okay. That's okay. Oh, nice. Bunch of steel here. What is this? It's kind of nasty. I'm not sure what it does. I'm not sure if I even want to get near it, to be honest. I don't know if it's deadly or not. Ooh, elephants. Wow, we haven't seen any other type of animal aside from those. And then I want to start a fight with them. I've done fight with large animals, and it's always with a crew of three or four. Because otherwise, nope. That's a dead wish, to be honest. So, better leave them alone. Even if they're peaceful, do not engage them unless you have the upper hand, weapon-wise or skill-wise. Or you have an auto turret back home. I mean, the auto turret could potentially save you. It doesn't mean it will, but it could potentially save you from death. Or from losing your entire, you know, colony, because that's happened to me in the past too, and it's not very nice. I've lost my shit to it, because it's something very stupid to do. You shouldn't do it unless you're 100% sure that you can pull it off. Lou, what do we do with you? Craft, Taylor, Smith, Plant God. The average for real skill is very low, so what does it mean? I mean, does it affect the amount, or is it just too slow? Because it doesn't really tell me anything. Wow, it's gonna be slow. Okay. just gonna leave this as it is right now. Pretty sure we can get enough food out of the jungle itself. Oh, nice. Nice. Okay. So you don't build it, but you still put them there. That's interesting. Oh, that's very cool. Oh no, wait, I thought it, oh no. My bad. I got a little bit excited there. Oh, I need to create a new stockpile. Still stockpile one, right? Okay. Yeah, I thought I had changed colors, but no. No. I thought that using different types of wood would mean different types of color for the wooden floor. That makes sense to me. Or at least different shapes, I don't know. But, no, apparently it's not the case, so, whatever. That's still fine, though. I mean, it's not a life-changing thing. Still gotta chop wood. Chop. With the wood friendos. We really need it. Oh, you're gonna cook? Nice. Alright. Okay, so spoils in 4 days. Now that's not good, obviously. So we have 4 days. Oh my god, 32 degrees inside. What? Oof, okay, that's gonna change the plans a little bit. I'm not sure how much the passive cooler is gonna help us, because I don't wanna go for engines or nothing yet. Oh, really? Oh, that's sad. That's sad, but it happens. That's nice. That's nice that they added such little details about the whole thing. Like, oh, it got rejected. Why? Because of this? Oh. Well, they talked about this or whatever. Again, it's very Dwarf Fortress-like. I would assume that they made a huge list of things that they could talk about. But that's just me. Okay. Can I move it? Nope, I think I cannot. No. Ah, okay. That's a very interesting thing that you can move the torch. I mean, I'm not sure why that would be the case. I mean, it's a torch. I don't see the problem with just picking it up and moving it into a different place. If I can move a table, for example, or a chair, or even the stove. Okay, so that's kind of weird, but fine, whatever, man, I don't mind, don't care. I mean, that's my own problem now, and when we don't have enough tables, that's another problem. Go for a walk, okay. Suit yourself, man. Yeah, if it wasn't for the very low expectations and initial optimism, we'll be in the tank. So we still need to figure out some of the stuff that we need to do to get them to be happier. Wow, that's just very little things that need to be fixed. Oh, it's already time to sleep? Really? Okay. Well, I mean, that's as far as we go. At least for this day. It's not that bad, though. It's not that bad. We're actually... We're making progress, even if it's slow. Because, you know, go figure it out. It's three people trying to survive in an unknown, uncharted planet. In the edge of nowhere. Or in the edge of somewhere. If you don't want to be that pessimistic. The sky was lit. Permanent summer. Ooh. Okay, that's new. Had never seen that before. Permanent summer. Wow, that's... Oh, that's horrible. Slept in the heat. Sorry. Sorry, I'm mismanaging here. But, you know what? We're gonna leave it here. We're making slow progress, but we're making steady progress. We still need to change and fix a lot of stuff, and we'll do that as we move along. I'll just probably throw these walls down, reuse it to build a storage, and just put all the cold stuff there. We're gonna need a generator, that's a given fact. We're gonna need a generator, be it fuel, chem fuel, wind turbine, I'm not so sure, because you need to clear up a lot of space. We need to clear up a big chunk for the wind turbine to work. So I'm not sure about that one, but we need to do something about it, because otherwise, food is going to spoil. Period. It's not going to last us. So, we need to do that pronto. And we need to also make individual rooms. Again, this is our temporary base, but we might as well use it and expand it as we move along. We're basically gonna use the forest at our advantage. We're gonna have to use guerrilla tactics also to survive the eventual raids from the pirates, because it's gonna start very, very mild. And we need to have a prison, and we need to have a medical bay, because we're gonna get people dropping in through pots. We're gonna have people that are just gonna come in and that are gonna be chased and may get injured, or may already be injured. We may need to fix the pirates so we can get them to join, etc. I mean, there's a lot of variables, but so what we need to do first of all is we need to finish setting up this initial base, this initial camp. We already got something growing up, which it's gonna take. I don't think it's gonna take too long for it to grow up, because it's never gonna be. Outside of its comfort level, the potatoes at least. Not so sure about corn, but I think it's also going to be safe, and same for rice. So we're always going to have food one way or the other. But we're going to have to make this a secure environment, because again, raiders will just try and burn everything down. That's a given fact. And I'm not sure, because I haven't seen it, if other factions will attack you. I remember that if you, at any given point, made them angry, or attack them, or whatnot, and they were neutral, they will eventually slaughter you. They will just come and beat you up. And I don't want this early on in the game, or in at mid level, because it can get very hard. If you have 7 or 8 people and you get 3 raids of 10, 12, or 14 people, because some of them could have energy shields, some of them could have automatic weapons. And we're not even talking about the robots that come with the ship, with the poison ship. We're not talking about the very weird stuff that they added, like the insects, that could just pop up. I'm not even sure how that works, but I'm a little bit afraid of having to deal with that, especially in a jungle environment, where it's so deadly. And we have medicine, but we're going to have to start planning medicine soon, or trading or something, because otherwise, those 30 medicine are just going to go right away. Like, just they're just gonna fly off the shelf. And then we're dead. We're dead, 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 dead. We're not gonna make it. So, this is what we're gonna do. This is how I hope that I can teach you how to do it, how to survive. I'm trying to do this as fast as possible. I'm mismanaging, I'm still picking up on the game. But if I would say that if you follow some of the steps that I'm providing you and you make your own changes, because adapting is what I'm all about, adapting to your environment, you'll be just fine. And again, I picked up characters that are not the best to start because I said, you know what, let's just do it. Let's just play with these characters. If I was playing in a harder difficulty, I would probably dead by now. So, take it from me. This game can get very hard and unfair when you don't make the right decisions. So always be careful when starting. I know that also wood is not the best thing to use for walls and floors, because they will burn very fast, but this is what we have. Eventually we'll change to stone if we can. If not, we'll continue working with wood and we'll go from there. Alright, so questions, comments, doubts, anything, even angry rants, just let me know in the comments. Remember to like this video, subscribe, click on that bell so you can get more notifications. I'll try and be more into RimWorld in the following weeks. So I'll try and be on the spot uploading videos at least once or twice a week on how to deal with stuff here. Alright? Thank you. Take care. Have a good one.